Nola Gent here at Pasquale's. Good stuff in here, yeah!
Welcome to Nola Gent. Let the good times roll.
In this episode of our USA travel vlog, we are visiting Laurel, Mississippi on our travel search for the best Mississippi Italian food options in the Laurel area. There is some good stuff in here, so we'll be sampling some great pizza, pasta, and sandwich options in this restaurant review video. The Laurel Pasquale's is located in a strip mall at 303 North 16th Avenue, which is about 2 hours and 140 miles away from the New Orleans French Quarter. Pasquale's is a chain that used to have a lot more locations, but many have closed, and it's a lot harder to find a Pasquale's these days. So let's go ahead and head on inside here and check this place out. This location of Pasquale's Italian restaurant has been around since 1969, and the building has remained virtually unchanged. I have been here several times in the past, but this is my first visit in decades, so I'm not really sure what to expect with the food here, and it's under new ownership. They used to be noted for a really great lunch buffet. I don't believe they have that anymore, though. The owner later did tell me that they have no plans to ever bring the buffet back, unfortunately. So they do have a nice selection of different sizes of pizza. And here you can see where the old salad bar of the buffet used to be. And then we have the entree selection for the buffet. So it was a nice little small buffet for pizza and pasta, and I will always miss it. The interior and exterior looks pretty much the same as I remember from my last visit, except they are missing the tabletop Pac-Man game I used to really enjoy. Well, let's go up to the order area and take a look at the menu to decide what we're going to eat today. So we have hot sandwiches with a hoagie, delicious Italian meats topped with pizza sauce and melted cheese, grilled chicken, lettuce, tomato, and mayonnaise, meatball, ham, turkey, stromboli, hamburger, sautéed onions and gravy, steak burger, roast beef, barbecue, choice of roast beef with zesty barbecue sauce, chicken, bacon, and ranch. You can add cheese or veggie to any sandwich, and all sandwiches served hot on our old world recipe Italian yeast bread. Pasta. Our authentic Italian pasta dinners are served with garlic bread. Spaghetti. Spaghetti covered with sauce, with mushrooms, with meatballs and mushrooms. Rigatoni. Thick tubular noodles smothered in a savory tomato sauce with seasoned meat and baked with mozzarella cheese. Then they have a child's pasta dinner and a lasagna. Then giant calzone made from our fresh homemade dough, made to order with your choice of meat and sauce, mozzarella included in all calzones. They have a cheese, a sausage, a ham, meatballs, turkey, barbecue roast beef, pepperoni, roast beef, hamburger, grilled chicken, supreme calzone, and meat calzone. You can add additional meat or vegetable or extra cheese. Then we have pizza with cheese, single topping, any two toppings, any three toppings, additional toppings. You have a 6-inch, a 10-inch, a 12-inch, and a 16-inch size pizza. Then toppings are Italian sausage, smoked turkey, jalapeno peppers, black olives, pepperoni, bacon, onions, banana peppers, green olives, grilled chicken, ham, mushrooms, hamburger, pineapple, green peppers, and extra cheese. Then we have specialty pizza with a supreme pizza, a meat lover's pizza, a chicken bacon ranch pizza, and vegetarian pizza. Then we have side orders with garlic bread, cheese bread, breadsticks with sauce, cheese sticks with sauce, meatballs, and then salads, regular side salad, large house salad, grilled chicken salad, large chef salad, mini chef salad, dressings or ranch, Thousand Island, French, Italian, blue cheese. So I got a spaghetti and meatballs and a sandwich, and my total was $21.30 before tip. My dining companion got a small vegetable pizza, which looks pretty darn good. And here's my stromboli sandwich and spaghetti and meatballs. This is a lot of pasta, bread, and carbohydrates in here. I don't know if I'll be able to finish all this, but it's been so long, I wanted to try it all out. So in the past, I always got this with some red gravy and cheese. I've never had it with this gravy before, and it's interesting, but I think I'd like it more ooey gooey with cheese and red gravy. This is not my preferred way to have it, I would say. So definitely, I wish they would bring back the option to get it with the red gravy and cheese. My sandwich is burning hot, so we're gonna let it cool down a little bit, and we'll just go ahead and grab one of these meatballs and taste this, because ooh, I love a good meatball. craving some red gravy, and this meatball looks like it's gonna give me a little good sample. Oh yes, I do like the meatballs here, and I like the red gravy. So this red sauce is very nice. I'm enjoying the flavors here, and the little meatballs are quite tasty. So this is an enjoyable dish, and the temperature is a little bit cooler than that really hot sandwich. And I have these two big pieces of garlic bread that I don't know if I'll be able to come anywhere close to eating after eating a sandwich and all this pasta. Here we go. So the pasta looks very nice. And let's go ahead and give it a little sample. And okay. So pasta is cooked perfectly. So very nice. And of course, I would like a little more red sauce in here because I am a sauce addict and I'm always in favor of more sauce. So certainly I would like everything more saucy in my life. Meatballs certainly are very nice and are hitting that need I had for some meat and red gravy that I wasn't quite getting from the sandwich. I do like some gravy, and brown gravy and meat and mushrooms is always good, but for just my personal preference and my experience here in the past, I just was expecting more of a red gravy with ooey gooey cheese on it. So it's just all about expectations and not confirming what I was getting. So this is more of what my memory recalls about this spot, and the meatballs and pasta pretty much seem the same as they always were. So I'm enjoying this little nostalgic flash to the past of several decades ago during my last visit. So it's a good little meal to have with all this bread. I could have been full with this alone and all this bread, but I wanted to sample more than one thing for this video so we could give a little more variety to all of you out there. And I was going to sample a piece of the pizza, but my dining companion completely destroyed her pizza before I even got an opportunity to take a little sample. So the pizza is good. It was reported to be very nice. The crust was reported to be quite crisp and delicious, and at some point I will have to make another visit to try the pizza, so I did not get to do that in this visit, and I'm really sad the buffet is not going on anymore because I was really hoping to be able to do a wide variety of different options from that to give a much more comprehensive review. But now I've totally destroyed the spaghetti and meatballs, so go ahead and destroy that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, comment below, let me know what you thought about the spaghetti and meatballs, and hey, while you're down there, it would help me a lot if you could check out my Patreon account and help me out with that. Thanks so much. Now let's try a little bit of this garlic bread and put a little red gravy on it and see how it is, because it has been a long time since I've tried this. Let's see. Ooh. So it doesn't look like it's super garlicky. I'm not really tasting a lot of garlic flavor to it, but it is good bread. They definitely have very good bread here. I've always been a fan of the bread. Let's get back to the sandwich. It's cooled down a little more, so let's give it another bite. So I ended up putting a little mustard on it because I was finding it a little dry without the red gravy on it and just the brown gravy on the bottom. But the top of the bun didn't have anything on it. It was supposed to come with grilled onions, and I really didn't see any grilled onions on here. So I was also lacking that. So, you know, these are very interesting times, and things are not quite up to what we expect all the time just due to supply limitations. And I'm lucky I've got the bread because I've heard Laurel is having a lot of problems just getting bread because so much of their bread is baked in New Orleans and shipped up. And there's still the Hurricane Ida situation going on with a lot of supply issues resulting from just lack of electricity and water supply issues and fuel issues. So we do have ongoing situations that are impacting the entire region. And I certainly am gonna be curious because I will be making a return visit back home to New Orleans soon. Although I'm still hearing from my friends that remained or just returned that the city is still far from normal. Although we're supposed to have power returned to most of the city by the end of this week, there's still lots of damage further south. So we're gonna have an ongoing situation for a while. So I'm a little antsy about that. So we'll see how that goes. Now we've totally destroyed that sandwich. So go ahead and destroy that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment below, let me know what you thought about this meal. And while you're down there, would you kindly check out the link to my Patreon account, because hey, I work for tips and I appreciate any assistance with that. And let's keep all the folks in Louisiana that are still suffering greatly in our thoughts and prayers. So, thanks so much to everybody at Pasquale's for decades of good food. And thanks so much to all of you out there for tuning into the Nolagent channel, especially to my Patreons. And if y'all could just remember to share this video with any of your friends or contacts who would enjoy it, it really would help me and I really would appreciate it. And make sure to tune in next time for more good food, good times, and good people.
Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. And if you would just click on the little circle here with a picture of my head in there and subscribe to the Nolagent channel, it would really help me a lot. I really appreciate it. Thank you.